मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, नाउ दिस इज 16th लेसन 10th क्लास सोशल स्टडीज. व्हाट इज दैट लेसन? नेशनल मूवमेंट इन इंडिया, पार्टीशन एंड इंडिपेंडेंस 1939 टू 1947. ओके चिल्ड्रन, सो दिस इज द लेसन. इन द प्रीवियस क्लास आल्सो वी डिस्कस्ड मेनी पॉइंट्स इन दिस लेसन चिल्ड्रन. सो हियर इफ यू लुक एट वंस अगेन द इयर्स बिटवीन 1939 टू 47 मींस this is the second world war time. In that second world war, some countries fought each other, allied group countries, axis group countries. In allied group countries, five countries are important. I said in the previous lesson, England, France, USA, USSR and China. In this axis power, Germany, Japan, Italy. Okay children, but our country then under the control of British. So that's why British government took our Indian soldiers to participate in the Second World War on behalf of British. Okay children? So but our Indian leaders questioned the Britishers how about the freedom of our country. But the Britishers accept the 1935 Indian Government Act. According to 1935 Indian Government Act, they allowed elections and stand as representatives of our country. So that's why in 1937 what happened, our Indian leaders stood and they won and they appointed as ministers, one person as appointed as Prime Minister. But the Prime Minister was at under the control of British official. Okay children, so that was the condition I explained in the previous lesson. Now look at here, I want to explain to you today about two sabhas or two groups. In our country, majority people are Hindus, minority people are Muslims, Christians, Buddhists, okay, Islam, etc. children. Now look at here, majority people formed one group that is called RSS. What is that? RSS. Minority people also, they started one league that is called Muslim League. What it is called? Muslim League. Actually, in our country, one party is there, okay, that is Congress, Indian National Congress. So this Indian National Congress conducting meetings every year. So in that meetings, from all country who are the delegates or who are educated people or who are national freedom fighters, they joined in this meeting and they discussed about the problems of our country and how to get independence from Britishers. So they are fighting for the independence of our country. So in this National Congress, Muslims are there members, Hindus are there as members, all kinds of people are there in Muslim Congress, Indian Congress as members. But what happened when Muslim League started? All Muslim League, all Muslims are supporting the Muslim League. Next one, Hindu Mahasabha or RSS. So this is also started by Hindus. So that's why many Hindus are supporting this Hindu Mahasabha and RSS. Actually, what about Muslim League? This Muslim League started in 1906. Very, very important. When Muslim League started? It is started in 1906. Actually, this Muslim League started for the purpose of some landlords, Muslim landlords, they are living in Uttar Pradesh. Okay children, so up to 1930, this Muslim League was not active. It did not strive for the separation of our country. But what happened after 1930, this Muslim League actively participating and fighting against the Congress party, and also it is asking for the separation of our country as separate nation. Okay, Now look at children. When Muslim League started, the Britishers observed the position of our country. Muslim League striving for the separation of the country. Hindu Mahasabha also working for India is for Hindus. Why? Because in our country, majority people are Hindus. So these Hindus believed, who are joined as members in RSS and also Hindu Mahasabha, they believed India belongs to the majority people of Hindus. Okay. Now here, that is why the Muslim League also, they are fighting and they are discussing with the British government to separate. Okay, children? So that is happening. So when these two groups are working for the separation of our country, then taking advance of British government, their rule is, we know, their policy is divide and rule policy. Before these two groups, Muslim League and Hindu Mahasabha, only one is there, that is Indian National Congress. In that Indian National Congress, all people joined. That means Hindus joined as members, Muslims joined as members. These all are fighting against Britishers to get freedom. Okay. But it is difficult to show the solution of Britishers. But when the Indian National Congress members partitioned and joined some people in Muslim League who are Muslims, some people is Hindu Mahasabha who are Hindus, etc., it is advanced to the British government. Okay, children? So that is why the Britishers encouraged Muslims. When Britishers encouraged Muslims, what happened here? Diversity can be seen over our Indian people, even though they are in Indian National Congress as members. Okay. Next one, the British government encouraged the Muslims and also they gave some seats as reservations for Muslims in that Muslim areas. Okay. Next one, it started in 1909, children. Okay. Next one, provisional government for elections conducted for provisional government in 1937. So in that provisional government also, League competed and League got out of 482 seats, it won 102 seats. Why? Because in that area, Muslims are living. So that's why they encouraged the Muslims to cast their vote to the Muslim League. So that's why the Muslim people realized and they casted their votes, who are the Muslims in that Muslim League. So that's why they got or they won out of 482 seats, 102 seats won. Okay, children? That means they are recognized by the British government. Next one, they are fighting for the separation of our India. Why? Because they wanted to form a separate nation. Okay. Next to children, Congress also won 26 seats out of 58 seats, even though that is Muslim area, in Muslim seats. Why? Because the Congress party or the Indian National Congress is actively participating for the unity of our country. Even at initial stage, many Muslims also believed it is not one religious party, it is our Indian party. Okay, so that is why initially even Muslims also encouraged and they supported to the Indian National Congress. That we can see. So that's why even though that area is Muslim area, okay, so the Congress got 26 seats out of 58 seats. Okay, children? Next, children, at the first time elections, the Muslim League got only 4.4% of seats in 1937 elections. Okay, but what happened after some years? Actually, this Muslim League is only active in some areas, mainly three areas. What are the three areas? United Provinces areas, Bombay and Madras areas. But this Muslim League is very weak in Bengal area, NWMP at present Pakistan area, and Punjab area. So in this area it was weak, but only in three areas it was very powerful and active. What are the two areas? United Provinces, Madras and Bombay. Okay children, but what happened after 10 years? After 10 years, Muslim League came to prominence. Okay, because they mobilized all Muslims. Okay, so that's why all Muslims are starting to support only Muslim League. They are not supporting to the Indian National Congress. Why? Because many Hindus, even though they are members in Indian National Congress, they are joined as members in Hindu Mahasabha and RSS. Okay, so we know what is the principles of RSS. So that is why many people objected the Indian National Congress members. Okay children, next one. In 1946, the provincial assemblies and also central assemblies, the situation changed tremendously. Next one, Muslims in 1937 to 1947, how they improved, what were their acts? So if you carefully observe, between these years they got to prominence because they became a strongest to powerful party. Why? Because all people who are Muslims, they believed they wanted to separate from Hindu areas. Okay children, so that is why they are asking a separate nation to Muslims. That is also happened here. The Congress party also refused to coalition government with Muslim League. Okay, so that is also one of the defects. Next children, Congress party banned who are the members in Muslim League. So when the Congress party banned who are the members in Muslim League, even Muslim League also questioned the Congress party leaders. For example, Maulana Azad, he is Muslim. So he is one of the powerful members in Congress party. So Maulana Azad questioned the Congress party leaders who are participating in Hindu Mahasabha. Actually, Hindu Mahasabha is a religious group. Okay, so that is why here Hindu Mahasabha and Muslim League, they are fighting. That means internal fighting occurred. Next children, Hindu Mahasabha and RSS. RSS means Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh. What is that? Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh. What is the main agenda of this RSS? India belongs to only for Hindus. Why? Because Hindus are majority people in India. So that's they believed. So that's why they started this group. They mobilized many Hindus and they encouraged many Hindus. Okay, so when they encouraged Hindus, even Hindus also they accepted, yes, India is belongs to ourselves only. It is not belongs to Muslims. So that's why the conflict occurred between Muslim League and RSS, that means Hindu Mahasabha. Okay, so in this way the Congress party became weakened. So when the Congress party, Indian National Congress weakened, many leaders who are members in Congress party, they explained to the Hindu Mahasabha members and also Muslim League members, it is our India. Okay, so we do not partition. Okay, so we do not encourage neither Muslim League nor Hindu Mahasabha because we are Indians. So they encouraged and they explained what problems occurred due to the Muslim League and Hindu Mahasabha. Okay children, so that's also happened. Because the Congress party always said our country is a secular country. Secular country means what? Secular means many religions are there. The country may not encourage any religion, may not disgrace any religion. Okay, neither encourage Muslim League nor disgrace Hindu Mahasabha. So that is called secular. So at religious matters, the state must be neutral. That is called secular. Okay, children? So the Indian National Congress said and explained to the Muslim League members and also Hindu Mahasabha members, our country is secular country. Okay, children? So this is about Muslim League and Hindu Mahasabha RSS. Now, next time, next class, I shall explain to you the remaining lesson. Thank you.